Hi, we're back again, John and Teresa, and we just want to touch base with you again this week. And I don't know about you, but I'm sure you are. We're very, very tired of what's going on, and we're ready to get back together and see you face to face and worship here in the worship center, the sanctuary at 9th and Main. And we've been talking with our leadership and praying and our staff, our wonderful team. And we have a date, a goal of mine. That's going to be Sunday, June 7th.
Yes.
That's going to take place.
Praise God. Yes.
Right here, two services, 9 and 11, 1 hour each. And we're going to be sending out some details, what that looks like, how we can be safe and secure. And so we've put it off and we're ready to get back. Mm-hmm. We need to be together. And I'm so thankful that we have been connecting, and I believe focusing and getting into the Word of God. And I just want to encourage you that the Lord's called us to an intimate, radical, personal relationship with Him. And so part of that is coming together on Sundays, worshiping together. But the greater part of that is every day of the week, living that out. We want to help you do that. And so when we get back together, we're not going to stop doing a lot of things we've been doing. We want to meet together. We want to grow together. And we want to reach our world right where we live for Jesus Christ. And so be encouraged. And a scripture I've been sharing this week is the words of Jesus, John chapter 16, verse 33. In this world, you'll have trouble, tribulation. You're going to have some problems. But be of good cheer. You can have a joyful peace in the middle of those things, even right now. A joyful peace, because Jesus says, I have overcome the world. And so that's our position in Him. And we want to say that we're here for you. We love you. And you're going to see things begin to open up. We're going to send out info and some other videos. What will it look like on Sunday morning? So get ready. And I really think, as we've been talking, it's a great time for us to pray. Say something about that as the people of God, to pray.
We continue to pray. I pray all the time. I pray the Lord's Prayer a lot, because I believe His kingdom come, His will be done. We pray for light to invade darkness, because I believe there's a lot of darkness right now. And we pray for truth to just flow like a river, and for justice to take place, and for people to be healed, both spiritually and physically. Mentally, at this time, people are struggling, and we want to be a place that is open and available to people to come, because there is nowhere in this world that you will receive hope like the Church of Jesus Christ.
That's right.
That is truly our only hope in this world, and we want to stand on that hope. So when you come back, we'll make it safe and secure to the best of our ability. The building will be clean. We will greet you, and we will not hug and do some of those things that we're used to doing, but we will do our best to do what we're supposed to do to keep everyone safe. But you know what? I'm not afraid.
Amen.
I'm not afraid at all, because I know that God is able to keep us from all those things that concern us right now. So let's press on. Press on right now in your personal lives, and let's just come together and enjoy God's house.
Amen. He's able to keep you in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed upon Him. He's our Savior. He's our Lord. He's our focus.
Hallelujah.
He's our everything. And so God bless you. We love you. And we'll see you online this Sunday. Amen.